Good morning. This is another broadcast of Chatting from the Word. I love that song because you know what? A change is coming. If you want your life to be in conjunction with the life of Jesus Christ, and if you have not made that change or made that step in your life to follow Him, that is a must. But what the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 11:1, follow me as I follow Christ. I am so glad to be able to come your way through YouTube and other entities that we are on. I am so glad that you have again put me in your scheduled time for today or whenever you are watching Chatting from the Word. On this show, we try to study God's Word in a more informative and way to try to help those that are truly seeking for the Lord. You know, the way day times are today and things going on in the world, that doesn't become easy. And sometimes we all need an encouraging word from time to time. It's good to get the encouraging word from time to time to hear that the Lord loves you and He cares for you. This is what Peter said, casting all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. It is a good thing that we have a Lord Jesus Christ who died for us and truly cares for us. He truly cares and He truly loves us. And again, if you have not subscribed to the show, please subscribe to our show, Chatting from the Word. I guarantee you it'd be worth your while. Subscribe to the show so when we are broadcasting or when we are put on broadcast that YouTube may notify you when it's broadcast. So Brother York won't have to do that. Please subscribe to the show. I'd be happy that you do that. And again, I'm looking for sponsors. I'm begging and pleading, if there's anyone out there who can sponsor Chatting from the Word, please see if you can put us in your budget. I believe that's worthwhile. I believe that it's a good thing just to study God's Word. I mean, what's the most beautiful thing to be getting ready to go to heaven and be with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Father through all eternity? I don't know about you, but I can't wait till the Lord come back and take us home. Those are in His body. Those that are truly are in His body and doing what thus says the Lord. Again, like I said, if anyone have read or seen my podcast, we started last Friday. I must admit, doing the podcast, I was a little nervous on my first day, but I believe all came out pretty well as it could come out. And if you want to call in to our podcast, call into our show. What you must understand, that the show is pre-recorded. You're not going to hear the show until we either put it on Facebook or Twitter or whatever. So please call in. Let me see if I can find the number for you. I had the number right here. I must say Brother York is not prepared as he usually be. But the number is, let me see if I can find it. The number is, the call-in number is area code 657-383-0883. Call in today. We're going to have a show at 2. We're going to be having the podcast at 2 today. So call in to that number. And once you call in, they will, first of all, probably put you on hold and then let you know it's your time to talk. So the area code again is 657-383-0883. So call in. If you have questions for me, that's good. If I can answer, we will try. We will search through God's word, through the scriptures for answer. And if you need a prayer, someone to pray for, we'll pray together right there on the show. So if you want to have a prayer request, that's the time to let your brother here let me know. And if you just want to talk, to say hi, that's fine too. I'd be happy to hear your voice. So please, if it's not taking too much of your time at 2, give me a call. Like I said, the show is pre-recorded. So call the number, and once you call the number, you will get my show, and you probably hear my voice. So call the show and talk and chat with me. I think that Friday, I'd have no calls. Like one call came in on the end, but we did our best to continue to bring the lesson about the Holy Spirit. That's what we was talking about. And today, I really am not sure what we're going to talk about today. We're going to get prepared to talk about something coming from God's Word. Like I said, that's a podcast from this show. And it's called, again, Chatting from the Word. As always, this is a praying program. We pray on this program. We love to talk with the Father and let the Father know what's on our minds and what we need and what we are suffering with. So, even much on this program, if you have something for Brother York to pray on, send me an email, Facebook me. I don't mind it. And if you want to comment on the show again, you can say it on the podcast or Facebook or email me or either through my webpage, Ask Your Publishing. You can always talk with your brother here, Oscar York. Let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven. Father, we're thanking you for allowing us to see another day, a day that neither one of us had never seen before. Father, we pray for the body of Christ, Father, the body that you died, that your son died for. Father, we thank you for allowing him to die on the cross, that we, through his unselfish act, may have salvation. And Father, we come praying for those that are having problems right now. God is what may be. Father, we recognize that sometimes living in this world can't be easy, Father. And sometimes we get lonely. We get all caught up in other people's lives, Father, and other people who don't mean us no good, always out want to destroy us. So, Father, we pray that you help those people and put a kind of mind and heart within them, and help us, Father, as we forbear the things are thrust upon us, Father. We recognize sometimes we got to go through the fire, Father. We got to go through the fire so we can be made in the image that you want us to be made in, Father. And Father, we pray for this show. We pray for our podcast. We pray for the lesson on our hearts this morning. We pray, Father, always that don't return to you void, but that may find lodging place in some man, some woman, some boy, some girl hearts, Father. and pray for the government of this land, Lord. We pray that the government never make a law forbidding us of worshiping you and praising you as you command me in your word, Father. In Jesus' name do we pray. Amen and amen. Like I said, I'm so delighted that you are with us today and this morning, whenever you're watching, chatting from the word. We're so glad that you are, and we hope and pray as always that you are getting something out the lesson. And today's lesson, we're going to try to bring to a close maybe next Monday, the Old Testament / the New Testament. And as always, if you're taking notes, your notes should be headed that way, like that, the Old Testament / the New Testament. And our studies are coming from the book of Hebrew. And I believe Hebrew is a good study for this, to prove that Christ paid the ultimate price when he died on the cross. Christ took the place of bulls and goats that the high priest did back in the Old Testament. And today we're going to study how the importance of Christ's death really means. I don't think many of us really don't recognize or either don't understand the importance of Christ dying on the cross. Now, imagine this, my friend. If Christ never died on the cross, where would salvation be? If Christ never died on the cross, neither one of us will have eternal life. If Christ would never have died on the cross and rose the third day, what situation would we be in today? I believe we would be in the worst condition there is, because that would aid to those who was atheists to not believe in Jesus Christ our Lord and our Father Yahweh. Because lots of people today are looking for reasons not to believe in Jesus Christ. And if it's not reason not to be faithful to him. Because the world sometimes has a way of grabbing at our coattails. And the world has a way of pulling us their way. And sometimes we got to, when that occurs, we got to dig deep in God's word for answers, for comfort. Dig deep in God's word that he may just keep us in the safety of his arms. Because that's what he does when the world pull and gnaw at us to come that way. So today we're going to study the importance of what Jesus did on the cross, what Jesus' death actually did on the cross. And so we're going to try to, I believe we're going to read from the ninth chapter, beginning with verse 15. And we're going to try to end at verse 20. And if you have your Bibles, open it to Hebrews 9, beginning with verse 14. And if you all don't have your Bible, go get your Bible. Go get your Bible, because I believe it's important that we study the Bible together. I don't want you to just take my word for it, but I want you to see it for yourself, what the scriptures may say. I know many of you might go back and say, well, Brother York, I'm going back and ask my preacher what you said is true. The only thing he can do is accept it, because you know something about me, we're reading the scripture. We just explain what thus says the Lord. Now, if he can explain that Christ didn't die on the cross, if he can explain that Christ didn't die for our sins, if he can explain that away, I doubt he can. And as I always said, if there's any discrepancies that you have with me about what I said about the word, email me, contact me. Now, since we got the podcast, you can ask it on the podcast. But always have scriptures to prove your point. Always have scriptures. See, most of us today, we don't want to live by scriptures. We want to live by what we think. But Proverbs say God ways is higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. So we cannot outguess. Some of us try to outguess what God may do or might not do. You see, we can't do that. We got to definitely, my friend, follow his word. And not to be able to follow his word or go in a different direction, you are in disobedient to God when you are thinking this is what God wants and we're going by what we want, thinking this is what God wants. We better go by this book. We better go by this book and instructions that Jesus died for. Well, brother, you cannot understand. See, Jesus died for the New Testament. And for us not to really don't want to go by the New Testament, well, basically what we're saying, Christ, you died for nothing. See, Christ died for the new way. And this is what we're going to study today. So if you have your Bibles, though, that had to go get your Bible, I hope you got it now. So just turn with me to the book of Hebrews. Verses 14 through 20. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promises of eternal inheritance. For where a testament is, there must also be necessity be the death of the testator. For the testament is of force after men are dead. Otherwise it is of no strength at all while the testator liveth. Wherefore neither the first testament was dedicated without blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkle both the book and all the people, saying, this is the blood of the testament which God hath enjoined unto you. On last week, if you can remember, I think we read the part where bulls and goats never could take away sin. What the sacrifice, what the high priest did by offering up bulls and goats, what it did, it just rolled back that sin back a year, and the sin came back, and the priest had to go into the holies of holies again and do it all over again, the sins for the people. But Christ, when he died, he died only once for our sins. See, God the Father. And this is what we must understand. And I believe some of us, we really can't grasp the love that the Father has for us. And what we must recognize that this is the love that God has for us. That he sent his son down from the beauty of heaven to die on the cross. See, that was God's mission from the beginning. He must have said it from the beginning when man first sinned, that he was going to allow his son to die on the cross. So that we are the sacrifice of his son, so that we may be connected back to him. That's the love, my friend, that God has for us, you see. And a lot of us don't want to accept that. A lot of us won't. And the reason why your brother here is saying that, because many of us want to live any kind of way. And when we do that, what are we saying to God the Father? We're saying, God the Father, we don't care if you love us or not. We're going to live for Satan. We're going to do whatever we want to do. We don't care if you love us enough to send Christ down on the cross and die for us. We don't care. We're going to live any kind of way we desire. We're not going to follow Jesus, nor are we going to pattern our life after Christ, you see. And by that kind of attitude, you saying to God the Father, I don't care that you send Christ down on the cross to die for me. I don't care if you love me enough to send Christ down. And we even said last Monday that Christ had enough love for us and for the Father, and obedient to the Father, that he faced the cross. Don't you remember his prayer in the Garden of Gethsemane? When sweat was falling from his body like blood, drops of blood. And Jesus said, Father, let this cup pass from me, if not your will be done. God, Jesus recognized he was there to do the Father's will. And his Father's will said, you must die on the cross for my people. Christ said, your will be done. I like what Paul said. Turn with me quickly to Romans. I like what Paul said in Romans 5. Paul said this in Romans 5. And keep your finger on Hebrews 9. Paul said this. Paul said in Romans 5, and I believe verse... is 6, beginning verse 6. Paul said, for when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some will even dare to die. But God commended his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Verse 9 said, much more then, being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him. See, Christ died for us while we were yet not sinners, and he now is pleading for us to be with him, to come to him, so that his blood can save you today. See, most of us, the problem is those that don't want to be the gospel, the problem is we are so much in the world that we can't let it go. We can't let it go. But I'm here to tell you this morning, my friend, that all of us has a day of reckoning. What Brother York means by that, we're all going to die. And being the fact that we're all going to die, we should want to live as close to the Father as we can. And here the Hebrew writer is saying, here, Now, if the blood of bulls and goats could just move away sin for a year, and then the priest said, how much more important is the blood of Jesus Christ? See, when Christ died on the cross, he died for you and me. He died so you and I may have a chance at eternal life. And most wants to just say no to the saving invitation. Most of us don't want to accept the blood of Jesus Christ. Most of us do not want the blood of Christ to cleanse our sins. Because most of us don't want to recognize that we're in the New Testament. Most still want to go back by the Old Testament, by the shadow. See, things in the Old Testament, that was shadow things to come. Salvation is here today, you see. The blood of Christ, saves us today. Today. And in verse 15, it said, and for this call, he's the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death, for the redemption of the transgression that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. That's what I've been saying. Christ died. And when he died, he became what? The mediator of the New Testament or the New Agreement. Well, we must understand, I believe that I covered this before, that when we're talking about a testament, we're not talking about the Old and the New Testament as is in the Bible, but we're talking about the agreement in Jesus Christ. Jesus died, shed his blood for the New Testament, for the better way, you see. And if we don't accept Jesus Christ, and I say many times, on his terms, and obey him from the pattern of the apostles in everything we do, when it comes to our worship, our even in our life, we should live for him. I mean, that is saying to God, I do not respect your love for me. That's telling the Christ, I don't respect what you did on the cross. You see. So, we should be every day as Christians, that we are in the body of Christ, we should be striving daily to live for him, knowing that he shedded his precious blood for you and I, knowing he died on the cross to open a connection for you and I to have with the Father. Knowing that he did that, what kind of people we should be, Peter said, knowing the terror of the world. Paul said, I persuade men. And this is what Brother York is doing today. I know none of us wants to die and go to HELL. All of us, when we die, we want the Father to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. All of us do. And if we want to hear those words, the best thing we can do is be in Jesus Christ. I know most of them say, well, I'm in Jesus Christ. You can't be in Jesus Christ and you're part of a denominational, because Christ is not divided. And that's what the word denomination means, division or divided. Christ is not divided, Christ is one. And Christ prayed that we all be one as him and his Father is one. And they agreed in everything. So how can you be in the body of Christ and be a part of the denominational world? You can't be, because when Christ died, we're talking about here, he died for the new and living way. We're going to end it here. We hope and pray that I've said enough to cause you to think, to cause you to say, I want to live for him more and more each day. To cause you to think that this show here is worth having on to hear the good news about Jesus Christ. Pray with me, please. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Father, for the many blessings you have brought our way. We thank you, Father, for your word. We thank you, Father, for so many things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. As always, visit my webpage, Ask Your Publishing. Order you a book. Come with reading, come knowledge, for knowledge come power. God loves you, and I do too. A change is coming. Love you. Have a good day. Be